ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ गणानां त्वा गणपतिकं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्रुण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक्प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्मोपनिषदम् माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्याम् मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्तु अनिराकरणं मेऽस्तु तदात्मनि निरते य उपनिषत्सु धर्माः ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः अन्यदेव तद्विदितात् अथो अविदितादधि इति शुश्रुमपूर्वेषाम् येनस्तद्व्याचचक्षिरे। सो आत्मा द ब्रह्मन् डजंट बिलोंग टू दी कैटेगरीज कैटेगरी ऑफ नोन एंड आल्सो टू दी अपोजिट कैटेगरी ऑफ नॉट नोन। यू सी इन दीज वाक्यास केनोपनिषद वाक्यास दे आर नॉट टू मेनी। उपनिषद इज अ स्मॉल वन रियली and half of it is anyway story. So in these vakyas we can discover a deep concern of the Upanishad to remove all traces of materiality and objectivity from the reality, from the Atma. Even a trace of objectivity should not be there. If it is known even on one occasion, it is not the Atma. So it is ever, ever the essential content of the subject or subjectivity itself. So that concern on the part of Upanishad to remove every trace of objectivity and materiality from human beings' conception of God, because we conceptualize a God. And ultimately end making the God material or an object of conception or conceptualization. So that way, to put it bluntly, we bring the God to the level of an object of the world, bring down the God to that level. In Andhra Pradesh I used to say, I don't know how many of you can appreciate that, we bring down the God to the level of N.T. Rama Rao. That is what we do. N.T. Rama Rao is a movie actor who played some of these roles of God's incarnation. And so we bring the God to that level. Nothing wrong, maybe he can play or he may not play, all that is separate. But our conceptualization of God should not be equivalent to what you see a person doing on the stage. So, if that is the case, then we are left with no God. This is the worry of theologians. No, not like that. In fact, in the place of an anthropomorphic God, the Upanishads give us a living God. In fact, the God in the form of life itself, which is the eternal self of the human being. That is the spirit of this agama, anyadeva tadviditat, atho aviditadadhi. So we were looking at that bhashyam. Tatha avidita dadhi ityukte anupadeyatva muktam syat. So avidita dadhi, vidita atho upari or anyat. So by denying all such efforts, such categorization, so because that is what we say, God is known. One gentleman comes forward and says, I know God. I am just now, I had a darshan, I had a vision of God, and now I am coming from God. So he puts the God in the, just like I went to California I was going on that Bel Air road, and unexpectedly I met Schwarzenegger, something like that. So, and then I come here and say, I met so-and-so. So, that is vidita. Now you have met somebody or something, but that is not God. Because anyatu viditat. Then somebody says, God is a paroksha. Theologians necessarily keep the God as paroksha. Means he cannot be anywhere on the earth. God in heaven, that in heaven, I see this in India. So in heaven is a necessary epithet for the word God. It is not God. It is not O God. It is God in heaven. O God in heaven. So a theologian, he is so sure that God cannot be anything to be known around. So even that concept of keeping the God in paroksha, non-local, away in some heaven, is also not acceptable. For some, you may say, that kind of a God is needed for a religion, and a society needs religion for social morals and ethics. Okay, you may have it. By all means, you have it. But then, when it comes to the understanding of reality, we don't go by sentimentality, and we should not go by personal predilections and all that. All personalities are kept aside, and the reality, we have to strive to understand it for what it is. Therefore, we cannot keep it in any of these concepts, and so anupadeya, it is you cannot grasp it. So it is not having any trace of objectivity. And this heya upadeya, Shankara is just has one or two more things to say about it. Let us hear that. Karyartham hi karanamanyat anyena upadiyate atascha na vedituranyasmai prayojanaya anyadupadeyam bhavatiti. You see, this upadana. Upadana means taking into our hands. So you take it and do something about it. So that kind of a thing you cannot do with reference to God. So you cannot hold the God with any of the means, like with the mind. You cannot grasp the God with the mind. Mind is a tool, you know. It's a tool. It is virtually, with a very subtle tool, you are holding on to something. Mind holds this object by knowing it as, by making it as an object of knowledge, as flower. So that way, by the time you end up grasping the God with the mind, then it is not the real God. It becomes a pseudo-God. So, because you know, anyena, anyat karanam karyartham upadiyate. This is the vakya. Very general, huge generalizations. There is nothing particular about it. Very elaborate generalization. Here is one, Vedita. He is the one who knows. This Vedita, what he is anyena. He remains distinct or separate from everything else. And anyat, upadiyate. So by this Vedita, and Vedita is the jnata, by this or drashta, the seer. So by the seer, something which is seen, and hence something which is different, is accepted or is taken into hand. And that something is always a karanam, it is a cause. So like clay, and this clay being the cause, it is taken into hand by the knower of the clay for the purpose, karyartham, for the purpose of making a pot, so that he can use that pot for something. So don't bring God to this level of worldly life. Don't do that mistake. So here I am, the knower, and I take God into my hands or whatever, and I worship it so that I will get something else later. So don't convert God into that kind of, don't make God accomplice to your personal desires and all that. At least you may like to do it that way, please do it, but the ultimate reality you have to know. That is the point. Atascha na vedituranyasmai prayojanaya anyadupadeyam bhavatiti. So the Ishvara or the Brahman, it is not vidita, it is not avidita. Therefore, here I stand apart from the God as vedita and anyasmai prayojanaya, and I have a purpose, a goal to be achieved, maybe heaven. And that goal is away from me, and it is different from me, away from me. Anyasmai prayojanaya. I am different, and as the knower, and the goal is different from me. It is not with me. I have to get, and so to get that goal, I need to start a starting point. I have to start with something which can finally give me that goal, and that something is God or Ishvara or Brahman, and that is different from me. I hold on to it and get that result. Ya aisa nahi hai. It is not like that. Anyadeva tadviditat atho avidita dadhi. So vidita is always karyam effect, because Shankara is introducing a new dimension to this whole discussion. Vidita, he did not say this karyakarana concept earlier. Now he is saying it. Vidita is karyam, the effect. Because the effect is always called vidita, known. Because you know the effect. And it is available for knowing either by perception or by inference or by thinking, intellection. You can know the effect. So you can see it or you can know it. You can see the necklace or you can intellectually see that necklace. It is vidita and it is karyam. And then karyam presupposes karanam. Karanam is always a vidita. I say this all the time. You can know the necklace only, you can never know the gold. What is gold, you tell me? Without invoking the cause, the effect, necklace or any ornament, you tell me what is gold? So, I mean, in a given way, in an example, you take the spirit of the example. Therefore, gold is not known to us. Only we know the effect of the gold. The ornament only we know. So, gold ever remains as avidita. And so, the universe is vidita, karyam. And the mayashakya vachinna Ishvara, so the saguna Brahman, so which we invoke to explain this universe as the origin of that, as the origin of this universe. So you always explain the effect by invoking the cause. So here is the viditam, and this viditam is the jagat, and it has a cause, karana karya bhava, you know. So it is the thing which is very much liked by tarkikas, the logicians. All logic, it revolves around karana-karya-bhava, cause-effect relationship. Then here is vidita, and then the saguna Brahman is avidita. So you hover between the vidita and avidita. Vidita is got from avidita. Avidita gives vidita. So you hover between the two. You are still relating to the relative truth only, not absolute truth. The truth, the Brahman, the existence absolute, it is beyond this vidita and that avidita. You have not yet reached the truth. It may be at the best, maybe a step towards the truth, all right, but not the final truth. So, this world which is known, vidita, and the cause of the world, the maya shakti, the avidita or avyakta. So atma, the jnana swarupa atma, akhanda sat, akhanda jnanam atma, it abides transcending this vidita and avidita. So from the atma point of view, I am not anything that is objectified. I am not connected with any of the objects of the world as a witness. I am not the body. I am not the mind, etc. I am not the ego. I am not any one of these things. Then I am all. I am everything. First is Viveka. The second is Sarvatma. Both Viveka and Sarvatma are prakriyas only. Neither one of them is not the final statement. When I say, I am not the body, I am not the mind, etc., that is not the final statement. When I say, I am all, even that is not the final statement. Because both statements are based on the conception, on the concept of a world. First, I assume that there is a world of things, and then I say I am none of those things, and then I say I am all of those things. But both statements, they hang upon this thread of a concept called world. And when I know that there is no world, I am the only reality, then I abide in myself. Without talking about I am not this, I am all this, all those things. I transcend the vidita and avidita, atma. I am not any of these things is said from one standpoint, I am all this is said from another standpoint. Assuming that there is a world, in itself atma is purnam. It is neither karana nor karya, neither vidita nor avidita. Like that, so it is said. Vidita is pratyaksha. What is before you? Avidita is paroksha. And so, nastikas say, Ishvara is not there. There is no Ishvara. Why? Why you say that? Because he is not vidita. The nastikas say, they say, if Ishvara can be there, only if Ishvara is vidita. You show me Ishvara. He must be vidita. If he is there, he must be vidita. That is what nastikas say. Astikas means not Vedantins. The theologians say, Ishvara is avidita, not known. Why? Because paroksha is not pratyaksha, is paroksha. So, theologians say Ishvara is ever in the heaven, and so he is paroksha. That is what the theologians say. And the funniest part is, these nastikas, these atheists, are agnostics, and the theologians, they come together on the same dais and start arguing with each other. Even to argue, you should have some common ground, you know. It's two boxers, one is standing on the ring, and the other is hanging in the air by some power. So can they box like that? So there must be some common ground. So here the person says, unless it is vidita, it cannot be the truth, nastika. And the theologian says the truth is avidita. And now about the truth they argue, how the argument is meaningful. In fact, we Vedantins say the truth is neither vidita nor avidita. It is neither paroksha nor pratyaksha. In fact, Shankara says in one place, I don't remember all these verses, it is there in Bhagavatam also, in Bhagavatam Dashamaskandha, there is a text, section called Shruti Gitas, or Vedastavam, in that the discussion is there. Here is a sadvadi. Sad is existence vadi. And here is a non-existence vadi. About the world. So, they argue with each other. And they are trying to say which is the truth. Truth is what is around us. somebody says, no, truth is in the heaven. So they argue each other, with each other. They should not have argued in the first place, but they argue with each other. And they neutralize each other. And we Vedantins watch the show. By neutralizing each other, they are only proving what we know all the time. That is, the truth is neither vidita nor avidita. So, like that. So, the truth is Svayam Siddha, the truth is Atma, a living God, not an anthropomorphic God. Then Shankara, he has a thing called Vakyartha. There are two Vakyas here, apparently. Vakya is statement. One is Anyadeva Tadviditat. The reality is distinct from the known, one Vakya. Then there is another Vakya, Atho Avidita Dadhi. And, Atho is and, the reality is beyond the not known. Two Vakyas. Generally, when it comes to Agama, Agama means the statement which helps us to know the reality that is received from the lineage of Maharshis, and that is anubhavanusari. It is what is totally realized by these Maharshis. That is the Agama. And that Agama cannot have two different sentences. It must have ekavakyata. That is what they say. Here, when we say two different sentences, the idea is not that an actual grammatical sentence, that is not what we are talking. Grammatically speaking, you need to put a full stop in between. So now there are two sentences technically. That is not what we are talking. Ekavakyata means, though there are apparently two sentences with a full stop in between, the combined meaning is not twofold, it is one. It is like, suppose there are two sentences. So, I am going to New York today evening. There is one sentence. Then, the elections will be held on November 2nd. There is another sentence. These are two sentences. And you write one after the other, continuously, and make it one paragraph. Now, how many sentences are there? Two sentences. Technically, two sentences. In spirit also, there are two sentences. Right? Now, another example I will give you. Today evening I am going to New York. After reaching New York, I will have some work there to be finished. I will do it. Now, how many sentences are there? Again, two sentences. But both together give one message, or they give two different messages? They give one message. So, this is what is called ekavakyata. In Shastram, this ekavakyata is very important. So, here, vidita, avidita, there are two sentences, but both of them put together, they don't point out in two different directions. It looks like that. It is different from the known, distinct from the known, and it is beyond the unknown. So, are they pointing out in two different directions? No. Both of them put together are pointing in one direction. The message is one. The spirit of the two sentences is one. That ekavakyata he has to establish. Because it is agama. Iti shushruma purveshani enastad vyache chakshire. He is not going to disturb, spend much time on it. Because it is what? It is incidental. We heard it from elders and they have explained it to us. It is all part of the story. In that, whether it is ekavakyata or two vakya, this kind of discussion is not important. But here, this is the agama. So, agama means, it is the only means of reaching the truth. There is no other thing that can signal the truth to me. That is what agama is, and so we have to be very clear about the agama. So he is taking up the discussion. We'll say that evam vidita vidita abhyam anyaditi heyopadeya pratishedhena स्वात्मनः अनन्यत्वात् బ్రహ్మ విషయా జిజ్ఞాసా శిష్యస్య నివర్తితా స్యాత్. ఓ ఇజ్ ఇట్ దేర్ యాజ్ అన్య బ్రహ్మ విషయ? ఓకే, ఫెయిర్ ఎనఫ్. హియర్ ఐ హ్యావ్ ఓన్లీ అన్యత్వ అనన్యత్వాత్ బ్రహ్మ విషయ ఇస్ దేర్, బట్ యూ హ్యావ్ అన్య బ్రహ్మ విషయ, లెట్ ఇట్ బి లైక్ దాట్. దట్ ఈస్ దట్ మేక్స్ ఇట్ మోర్ క్లియర్. సో యు సీ బ్రహ్మన్ ద ట్రూత్ ఈజ్ నాట్ విదిత అన్యత్, విదితాత్ అన్యత్, అండ్ ఆల్సో ఇట్ ఈస్ అన్యత్ అవిదితాత్. బై నౌ ఐఎమ్ షూర్ యూ మస్ట్ హ్యావ్ గాట్ దీస్ వర్డ్స్, సో దట్స్ వై ఐఎమ్ యూజింగ్ దెమ్. ఎవ్రీ టైమ్ ఐ కెన్ ట్రాన్స్లేట్ ఆల్సో ఐ డూ ఇట్, బట్ ఐ సపోజ్ యూ హ్యావ్ గాట్ దోస్ వర్డ్స్ బై నౌ, బికాజ్ ఐఎమ్ సేయింగ్ దీస్ వర్డ్స్ విదిత అవిదిత సిన్స్ ది లాస్ట్ టూ డేస్ like a goat says meh 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 meh, it doesn't say any other thing. So similarly I say vidita 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 vidita. So anyat vidita avidita abhyam, it is distinct from the vidita, the known, and also the avidita. Then what is the spirit of it? What is the conclusion? Heyopadeya pratishetha. Don't try to grasp it or try to push it away. It cannot be rejected. No, I don't want Brahman now. You can't do that. You are Brahman. No, I want Brahman now. You can't do that either, because you are Brahman. You are not going to grasp it. So, it is not something to be available, something available as a result of an action. The action could be pravritti or nivritti, whatever. Heya Rupadeya it is not. So that was dejected. Why so? Because Svatmanaha Ananyatvat. That is the Hetu. That is the reason. Because it is never different from your own essential content. When you say I, do you know the meaning of the word I? You do not know. You do not know. So, for example, suppose you say, I ask you, give me the meaning of the word I. So you give a meaning. That meaning points out to a individual, to a person, right? Suppose I asked one gentleman, sir, you give me the meaning of I. He gave me the meaning of I on a piece of paper. And so that I means a person. Now I asked a lady, Amma, you give me the meaning of I. She gave me the meaning of I, but now the meaning of I is not same. It is now the meaning of I is altogether a different person, of a different gender, of a different this and a different that. Now, which is the real I? Suppose one word is given different meanings by different persons, do you accept it? So what is the real meaning of I between these two? And suppose you take a dog. It knows that it exists, it knows what is this I am, it knows, and if it doesn't, if it has language, human language or human mind, and ask it to give the meaning of I, it will give a particular meaning of I, which represents a person, an animal person. Now what is the real meaning of I? In these three occasions, the sense of I is there, but the real meaning of I is not understood. If the real meaning of I is understood, then the meaning of I in the case of this gentleman, and in the case of that lady, and in the case of that dog cannot be different. Because, so vidyavinaya sampanne brahmane gavihastini shunichayvashvapake cha panditas samadarshinaha. And if it is different, if it is understood as different, he is not a pandita, he is not a jnani. And in the vision of a jnani, the I is same. Because the meaning of I is sentience. The gentleman, before knowing anything else, he knows that he exists. The lady, before knowing anything else, she knows that she exists. Even before she knows herself as a she knows that she exists. And the dog, it knows that it exists, and a caterpillar knows that it exists. That is the sentience. And that is the real meaning of I, and that is the only meaning of I. And that is the only God. That is the Brahman, that is the truth. And that real meaning of I is neither known nor not known. Svatmanaha ananyatvat. And so now the Shishya, the student, Shishyasya Jignasa, the student has a desire to know. We all want to know Brahman. You see, even while desiring to know the Brahman, that idea that Brahman is something other than me is there. It is like yesterday I told, I want to see God. Why should I want to see God? What for? Why? Asal, why that desire is there in the first place? You know why? Because I already told what I am saying again. So because I take myself to be a body, that's why I desire to see God. I identify with the eyes. Body means what? I have a pair of eyes and I see things and things and things, and so now I want to see God. Suppose I am not the one who sees, then what happens? A sakshi. So this desire to know God is a qualification, is an epithet or an attribute for the ego, not for the sakshi. So a shishya, he takes himself to be a student. That is also adhyaropa. Atma is not a student. So I am a student. This is adhyaropa. Like saying I am a father is an adhyaropa. I am a student is an adhyaropa. Adhyaropa means superimposition. So I am a student. Who is a student? One who is desirous of knowing. Jijnyasa. Okay, what is it that you desire to know? Brahma. What kind of Brahma it could be? Which is an object of my desire to know? It could only be Anya Brahma. So this Jijnyasa, Anya Brahma Vishaya Jijnyasa, Nevartita Syat. If he is a proper student, by the time it is said as vidita, different from vidita, distinct from vidita and distinct from avidita, this kind of a jijnyasa will disappear. Now, I don't have any desire to know Brahman. Nivartita asyat. Because the origin of the desire is based on ignorance. Ignorance of the truth. The truth is, I am the Brahman. And that truth is unknown, and so I am ignorant of that fact, and so I wanted to know the Brahman. Now, I don't want to know the Brahman, because I am the Brahman. I kept the Brahman in the category of unknown. I kept the Jagat in the category of the known. So even when I say it is known, it is false. And I then kept the category Brahman in the category of unknown, and so I want to know the Brahman, even when I say I am ignorant. So that's why we say, based on, again this discussion has a practical implication. That is, it is not academic. The practical implication is, as long as you have a desire to know Ishvara, you will not know Ishvara. So, one should learn to surrender the spiritual anxiety also. Just be the witness. Be the witness means, you hold on to some concepts, that is not the witness. Witness means utterly unattached, then only you call it witness. Therefore, it is the ego which says it is better to know Brahman. Then, okay, this is how ego functions. Because it thinks that it is different from Brahman. That's why it wants to know Brahman. Anya Brahma Vishaya Jijnyasa. And so it is the ego which is the student. I am the Atman. Already I transcended this division of Brahman separate and I am separate, etc. So this is how even the jijnyasa has to be removed, nivartita. Jijnyasa removed means don't misunderstand it. Jijnyasa removed means earlier he thought he will study Vedanta. Now after hearing this he decided not to study Vedanta. Don't look at it that way. It is possible to look at it that way, that is not the right way of looking at it. So, finally, the goal is not to study the Vedanta, the goal is to know that I am Brahman. And studying Vedanta is a stepping stone. So, శ్రోతవ్యః దట్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ది గోల్, దట్ ఈస్ ది మీన్స్. ద్రష్టవ్యః ఇస్ ది గోల్. సో దట్ ఈస్ హౌ. నహి అన్యస్య స్వాత్మనః విదితా విదితాభ్యాం అన్యత్వం వస్తునః సంభవతి. సో దట్ ఈస్ శంకర. హి సేస్ స్వాత్మనః అన్యస్య బ్రహ్మ విదితా విదితాభ్యాం వస్తునః అన్యత్వం న సంభవతి. దిస్ ఇస్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఇస్ నాట్ పాసిబుల్. వాట్ ఈస్ ఇట్ దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ పాసిబుల్? నహి సంభవతి, ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ఎట్ ఆల్ పాసిబుల్, మీన్స్ ఇంపాసిబుల్. వాట్ ఈస్ ఇట్? సో ది మై ఎసెన్షియల్ నేచర్ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్ అన్యస్య స్వాత్మనః, అండ్ ది బ్రహ్మన్ విచ్ డజంట్ ఫిట్ ఇన్ టు ది కేటగిరీ ఆఫ్ నోన్ అండ్ ఆల్సో నాట్ నోన్. సో దట్ వస్తు, దట్ రియాలిటీ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్. దట్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ డిఫరెన్స్ ఈజ్ జస్ట్ నాట్ పాసిబుల్. బికాస్ ఇఫ్ బ్రహ్మన్ రిమైన్స్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ ఐ, ఐ హ్యాపన్ టు బి ది వేదిత, బికాస్ దేర్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ వన్ వేదిత ఇస్ ది నోవర్. I happen to be the knower, and there is only one knower in this universe, that is you. When I said this to a student, he said, Swamiji, what about him? That is what he asked. some five people or 10 people are sitting and taking a class. I said, you are the only knower in this universe. Then he could not control himself. He said, what about this fellow? Then I asked him, okay, I appreciate your goodwill and sympathy for him, but you tell me, is he the knower or is he the known? He is the knower. Oh, come on, think properly and answer properly. You say he and say knower. No, so while you say he, how can he be the knower? Only I can be the knower. He cannot be the knower. He can only be the known. So, how can you have a second knower? The second can only be the known. It cannot be the knower, you know. This is the problem. That's why I say, this is the answer which I gave the other day. The universe for all of us is same. The world for all of us is same. Whereas dream world is different. That kind of a question. So I try to answer on similar lines. It's okay. So that kind of a difference is not possible. You just can't have a God outside of you. You being the Vedita, the knower, you can't have the God outside of you. Suppose you are the Vedita, knower, and God is outside of you, then this God will be either known or the not known. He cannot be simultaneously different, distinct from the known and also beyond the unknown. How? While I am the Vedita and Brahma is Anya, then he falls into the category of known or not known. But now you say Vidita Vidita Abhyamanyat. It is distinct from known as well as unknown, means it cannot be other than what the essential nature of knower is. There cannot be a trace of objectivity in the Brahman. Then, iti atma brahma ityesha vakyarthaha. So this is the vakyartha. Because of these reasons, even while saying two statements, it is distinct from the known, and it is beyond the unknown. So while saying those two statements, vakyarthaha, the distilled meaning of both those statements is atma cha brahma. That is the meaning. Atma being the essential content of the Vedita, the knower. Atma cha brahma ityesha vakyarthaha. This means, what do you know? Even while worshipping God, in temples or in churches, etc., even while worshipping God, we had been always worshipping our own hidden self. That is the truth. You did not know it, But that is what you have, what you had been doing. So, suppose you proclaim a God in words, saying that the God is in heaven, etc. Or you fix a murti, a form before you, and say that this is the God. So, both situations are same. In one case you say the God is known before you. In another situation you say the God is in heaven, proclaimed by speech. The unknown, the not known, both are not different. Both make the God an object of the Vedita. So, in both cases, in fact, we say the idol shaped by speech and the idol shaped by hand, both are one and the same. Both are idols only. So when you say God Pratyaksha and when you say God Paroksha, in both cases, there is not essential difference. You are making the God an object of the Vedita's vision or understanding. Either it can be characterized only in the Vedita's knowingness, you can have two categories, known, not known. And so you are trying to fit the God into one of these two categories. Both ways it is same, though they say that we are different like that. So nobody is different. Both are doing the same thing. So Atman, which is the immediate, direct and innermost self of all, is the only God, is the God. So what happens, you know, while you have a religion, you see, religion should never be dissociated from philosophy. Religion has a relevance. While saying that Atma is the God, we are not knocking off the religion. Please note that point. Because here, some of these statements could be very devastating. In fact, once I taught this Kathopanishad in Telugu, in vernacular it could be even more devastating. In English, which I learn and speak in English, I cannot be as emphatic or effective as I am in vernacular. Vernacular is, it is part of the person itself. Mother tongue, you know, they call it mother tongue. And I was teaching this Keno Upanishad, and I don't know how to teach other than the way I teach. A teacher is not a person. A teacher is the teaching. And then there is the book, and there are the sentences, there is Shankara's Vishan and Upanishad, and so I was doing the job, incidental it is. It is not contrived or planned or any such thing. I do not teach. Teaching happens incidentally. I am not a professional teacher. Teaching happens, it is incidental. All work happens incidentally. So, then these statements are going on, and some of the people said, Swamiji, these statements are too devastating, and it is like thunderbolts are falling on the head. That is what they said. I said, I don't know what to do about it. So, but the fact is, the Vedantic philosophy, it doesn't negate the religion. It reconciles the religion. The society needs, this is an apology it is. Now apology starts. Having taught the vastu, apology starts. You have to be apologetic also for teaching the vastu. So the apology is, the society needs religion. You see, even while saying, I am saying as if there is a society other than Atma. But then let me say it. So the society needs religion. Religious ethics and religious morals are needed and for the society, because society consists of people who are ignorant. You see, I don't like to say it, but then I have to say it as part of apology. So society and ignorant people need the religion. And so Vedanta reconciles it. And a religion, but this is from the social point of view, this is the truth. The religion, it needs a God different from the devotee, all right, whether before you or in the heaven, whatever way. Both have their own points. But the point is, a religion should not be dissociated segregated from the philosophy. In India, we find most of the religions, not all, there are many religions in India. Religion means what? Mode of worship. I am not talking of an organized religion and all that, a mode of worship. Religion is a mode of worship. Somebody worships Krishna, somebody else worships Rama, a third one worships Shiva. So like that there are many. Hinduism is a huge tree. Many religions are sustained under that tree. So Hinduism is a way of life, it's not a religion. And it includes quite a few religions within its fold. So all these religions, most of them, have a very strong background of philosophy. Even while worshipping a non-self God, they seem to know that ultimately there is no difference between the self and the God. As of now, I worship the God who is different from me, which is okay, which I take to be different from me, which is all right. But ultimately, there is going to be a communion. So on that basis, the religions proceed. And so that kind of having roots in the philosophy makes the religions tolerant and Catholic. That approach of Catholicity that becomes inherent to the religions. But if a religion takes the division between the self and God to be ultimate, and the division is the truth, then such a religion is totally segregated from philosophical comprehension, and so the religion ends up as a dogmatic, narrow and exclusive minded. Like they say, my truth is linear and that is the only truth. Nobody else knows the truth. What is that truth? He is different from God. What is the other truth which he denounces? Same thing. The other truth also, he is different from God. Then what is the conflict between the two gentlemen? I am worshipping Shiva. I am different from Shiva. He is worshipping Vishnu. He is different from Vishnu. Then what is the conflict? There should be no conflict. Because good or bad, both are in the same boat. The Atma is different from the Brahman. That is the boat. So why there should be any conflict? Do you know what is the conflict is all about? The conflict is about the name. It is about the name. What a misfortune. Human mind cannot cross the limitation of a name. So finally you go and establish yourself in a name. What a huge misfortune it is. And so the philosophical comprehension, not that the self is the ultimate living God, the real self. We are not saying that the egoic self is God or any such thing. Egoic self is a false entity. It is neither God nor individual. Leave alone being God, it is not a real entity at all. So the real self is the only living God. While this is the Vakyartha, this is Shankara's message, Upanishadic message, but then Shankara's message. What happened is the Upanishadic message was covered up by so much of Karmakanda in the days of Shankara. All the Mimamsakas are hardcore religionists in a way, so they have virtually submerged this message under the smoke of fire. Dhuma, Dhumita. Bhagavatam says that. Dhuma, you know. So, then Shankara, he reconciles the Karmakanda, but he presents the truth and tries to re-establish the connection between the religion and the philosophy. So, Atma, Brahma, Ityesha, Vakyarthaha. The logic is impeccable. If the reality Brahman is neither the known nor the not known, then it cannot be anything other than the self itself. It cannot be anything other. That is the conclusion. You just can't escape that conclusion. Atma cha Brahma ityesha vakyarthaha. So now Shankara says, this is not that only Kanas told this truth. There are other Upanishads which say the same truth. But the language is different. The words are different. Expressions are different. మెథడాలజీ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్ బట్ రియాలిటీ ఈజ్ వన్. అయమాత్మా బ్రహ్మ య ఆత్మా అపహత పాప్మా యత్ సాక్షాద్ అపరోక్షాద్ బ్రహ్మ య ఆత్మా సర్వాంతరః ఇత్యాది శ్రుత్యంతరేభ్యశ్చేతి. శ్రుత్యంతరేభ్యః అదర్ శ్రుతీస్ ఫ్రమ్ ది అదర్ శ్రుతి పంచమీ బహువచనం. సో ఫ్రమ్ ది అదర్ శ్రుతీస్ ఆల్సో వి గెట్ ది సేమ్ వాక్య, బట్ ది మెథడ్ ఈజ్ స్లైట్లీ డిఫరెంట్. హియర్ ది మెథడ్ ఈజ్ వెరీ వెరీ పవర్ఫుల్. విదిత విదితా అన్యద్ విదితాత్ అండ్ అథో అవిదితాత్, వెరీ వెరీ పవర్ఫుల్ మెథడ్ అండ్ వెరీ డివాస్టేటింగ్ మెథడ్ ఆఫ్ ప్రజెంటింగ్ ద ట్రూత్. ఇట్ ఈజ్ లైక్ లుకింగ్ ఇన్ టు ది గ్లేరింగ్ సన్. ఎనీవే, అయమాత్మా బ్రహ్మ, అయమాత్మ, దిస్ అయం రిప్రజెంట్స్ ద ఫిజికల్ ఉపాధి అండ్ ఆత్మ రిప్రజెంట్స్ ద రియాలిటీ రిఫ్లెక్టింగ్ ఇన్ ది ఫిజికల్ ఉపాధి అండ్ దట్ రియాలిటీ ఈజ్ బ్రహ్మ, ఇట్ ఈజ్ పూర్ణం. య ఆత్మ అపహత పాప్మ, యు సీ యు టేక్ యువర్స్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఛాందోగ్య, అగైన్ అ డిఫరెంట్ కాంటెక్స్ట్. సో అయమాత్మ బ్రహ్మ ఈజ్ మాండూక్య, కాంటెక్స్ట్ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్. సో యాజ్ ది కాంటెక్స్ట్ డిఫర్స్ ది మెథడ్ ఆల్సో డిఫర్స్ యూనో. సో యు టేక్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ టు బీ ఏ వర్చ్యువస్ పర్సన్ ఆర్ ఏ పర్సన్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆపోజిట్ సిన్నర్. యూనో సిన్నర్ బట్ పీపుల్ డూ టేక్ లైక్ దట్ ఐ హ్యావ్ కమిటెడ్ ఎ సిన్ అండ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ ఎక్వైర్డ్ ఎ లాట్ ఆఫ్ వర్చ్యూ. సో బోత్ పుణ్య అండ్ పాప దే కాల్ పుణ్య పాప. పుణ్య ఈజ్ వర్చ్యూ, పాప ఈజ్ ది ఆపోజిట్. సో పుణ్య పాప బోత్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ ఇన్ ఉపనిషత్ దే ఆర్ పాయింటెడ్ అవుట్ బై ఎ సింగిల్ వర్డ్ అండ్ దట్ వర్డ్ ఈజ్ పాప్మ, నాట్ పాప, పాప్మ. వెన్ ఎవర్ యు సీ పాప్మ ఇట్ ఈజ్ ది కంబిన ది పెయిర్ ఆఫ్ ఆపోజిట్స్ పుణ్య పాప. దట్ పెయిర్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ పాప్మ. దిస్ పాప్మ ఇట్ హాంట్స్ ద ఇండివిజువల్. సో ద ఇండివిజువల్ వాంట్స్ టు ఎక్వైర్ పుణ్య అండ్ గెట్ రిడ్ ఆఫ్ పాప. సో అల్టిమేట్లీ దేర్ మే బి డిఫరెన్స్ ఇన్ పర్సంటేజెస్, మోర్ పుణ్య లెస్ పాప, ఆర్ మోర్ పాప లెస్ పుణ్య, ఆర్ 50-50, త్రీ ఆఫ్ దెమ్. సో ఓన్లీ త్రీ పాసిబిలిటీస్ యూనో ఇన్ జనరల్ వే. సో ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ గీత ఆల్సో సేస్ ఆల్ దిస్ అనిష్టమిష్టం మిశ్రించ త్రివిధం కర్మణ ఫలం, సంథింగ్ లైక్ దాట్. సో పుణ్య మోర్ పాప లెస్, పాప మోర్ పుణ్య లెస్, 50-50, త్రీ ఆఫ్ దెమ్. దీస్ త్రీ సిచ్యువేషన్స్ ఆర్ ఫర్ హూమ్? ఫర్ ది ఇండివిజువల్. ఆత్మా అపహత పాప్మా, దీస్ సిచ్యువేషన్స్ దే డు నాట్ బిలాంగ్ టు ద రియల్ సెల్ఫ్, దే బిలాంగ్ టు ద ఫ్యాంటమ్ సెల్ఫ్ కాల్డ్ ఈగో. దే డు నాట్ బిలాంగ్ టు ది ఆత్మ. ఆత్మ ఫర్ అస్ ఈజ్ వెరీ సీక్రెట్. ఇట్ ఈస్ బ్రహ్మన్. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ టు బి టచ్డ్ ఈవెన్ బై దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ పుణ్యం అండ్ పాపం. దే వోంట్ ఈవెన్ టచ్ ది ఆత్మ. కర్మణా వర్ధతే నోకనీయ. ఇట్ ఈస్ ది ఈగో విచ్ గ్రోస్ బై పుణ్యకర్మ అండ్ విచ్ ష్రింక్స్ బై ది ఆపోజిట్ కర్మ, నాట్ ది ఆత్మ. ఇట్ రిమైన్స్ ఇన్ ఇట్స్ ఫుల్ గ్లోరీ లైక్ ది ఓషన్. వెన్ రెయిన్స్ కమ్, ఓషన్స్ డోంట్ రైజ్ ఇన్ లెవెల్ ఎట్సెట్రా. ఇట్ ఈస్ ది ట్యాంక్ విచ్ రైజెస్ ఇన్ లెవెల్. అండ్ వెన్ దేర్ ఆర్ నో రైన్స్, ఓషన్ డజంట్ ష్రింక్, ఇట్ రిమైన్స్ సీ లెవెల్ ఈస్ కామన్, ఇట్ డజంట్ చేంజ్. ఆత్మ ఈజ్ లైక్ దాట్. సో దట్ దేర్ ఆల్సో ది ఆత్మ ఈజ్ ప్రెజెంటెడ్ యాజ్ దిస్ కర్మఠాస్ ఆర్ ది కర్మీస్ ఇన్నర్ మోస్ట్ సెల్ఫ్. య ఆత్మ అపహత పాప్మ, హీర్ ఈజ్ ఎ కర్మి, హీఈ్ వర్షిపింగ్ ది గాడ్ త్రూ కర్మ అదర్ దాన్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్, బట్ ది గాడ్ ఈజ్ ప్రెజెంటెడ్ యాజ్ ది ఆత్మ, ది ఇన్నర్ మోస్ట్ సెల్ఫ్. దెన్ యత్ సాక్షాద్ అపరోక్షాద్ బ్రహ్మ య ఆత్మా సర్వాంతర, దిస్ ఈజ్ బృహదారణ్యక. ఇట్ హ్యాజ్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్ ఫ్లేవర్. ఇట్ సేస్ లైక్ దిస్, యత్ సాక్షాత్, సాక్షాత్ ఈజ్ అవ్యయం, ఇట్స్ ఇండెక్లైనబుల్. అపరోక్షాత్ ఈజ్ నాట్ పంచమే ఏకవచనం, ఇట్ లుక్స్ లైక్ పంచమే ఏకవచనం. అపరోక్షాత్ మీన్స్ అపరోక్షం ఇత్యర్థ శంకర భాష్యం. సో యత్ సాక్షాద్ అపరోక్షాద్ బ్రహ్మ అపరోక్షం ఇత్యర్థ, దేర్ ఈజ్ నో పంచమీ దేర్, అపరోక్షం. యు సీ దిస్ డిస్కషన్ ఈజ్ లైక్ దిస్ ఇన్ బృహదారణ్యక భాష్యం. దేర్ ఈజ్ ఎ ఫ్లవర్, ఇట్ ఈజ్ ప్రత్యక్ష, Because Aksha is there, you know, that's why I am building it up like that. It's Aksha, Sakshat, is Akshat it is. And Aparokshat also Aksha. So it is Pratyaksha. Then heaven is Paroksha. Paroksha means it is not available for perception. It is Paroksha. Now I will ask you a question, just to alert you. Suppose there is a mood of the mind, mind's mood, either pleasant or painful, whatever. Is it Pratyaksha or Paroksha? It is none. It is neither. Because it is not Pratyaksha. You do not see the good mood of the mind before you, you know. It is not available for seeing with sense organs. Therefore it is not Pratyaksha. But then it is not like heaven also. Heaven is, it is Paroksha. So your mood of the mind is very real for you. It is not like heaven. Therefore we have a third category. It is called Aparoksha. The mood of the mind is Aparoksha. Similarly, intellection, that scholarship, etc., is Aparoksha. It is known to you. But not known through perception. And not unknown like heaven, Paroksha. So it is Aparoksha. Now, this Aparoksha, that is the mental state, the state of the mind, it is known to whom? Sakshi. Under this Sakshi, it is knowing Aparoksha, but then it knows itself also. Aparoksha needs Sakshi to be illuminated, but Sakshi doesn't need any other thing to be illuminated. So Sakshi is not Aparoksha, because Aparoksha needs Sakshi to be illuminated. So Sakshi falls in another category, which is not Aparoksha. Aparoksha means he becomes another aspect of the mind only. Being the witness of the mind, the awareness, the chaitanyam, it falls in an entirely different category. It is not Pratyaksha, it is not Paroksha, it is not Aparoksha also. There is a fourth category, Turiya. Chaturtham manyante. The fourth category. Category like category. It's not that it is a category. Category eva category. So, that category is called Sakshadaparoksham. That is the category. That is the category. Sakshadaparokshat means Sakshadaparoksham. Yat Sakshadaparoksham. If only you have that inner vision, that insight, you should be able to know that there is a awareness which is Sakshadaparoksham. It doesn't fit into the three other categories. That Sakshadaparoksham, that is the awareness, it is there. You must be knowing it. Yat Sakshadaparokshat, whatever Sakshadaparoksham, the awareness is there, that must be known to you, that you are that. It is not unknown to you. You must be familiar with it. Yes, we are familiar with it. Then that is the Brahma. Yat Sakshadaparokshat, Brahma. Oh, I am Brahma Jignasa, you know. I want to know the Brahman. Yeah, you want to know the Brahman. May God bless you. But do you know Sakshadaparoksham? Yeah, I know Sakshad. I know means not that I know as a flower. I am familiar with it. That is the word. I am familiar with Sakshadaparoksham. Okay, then what is the problem? Yat means all this. Yat Sakshadaparoksham. Whatever Sakshadaparoksha is there that you are familiar with, that is Brahma. Then if that is the Brahma, then why should I know Brahman? Yeah, you need not know Brahman. Then why should I gain Brahman? You need not gain Brahman. You are Brahman. Yeah, Atma, that is the Atma. Sarvantaraha. Not only the Atma for an individual, it is the Atma for the entire creation. It is like one sun reflecting in a billion dewdrops. Each in antahkarana is like a dewdrop. This is the teaching in Brihadaranyaka. Ityadi shrutyantare bhyascha. Like this there are many other shrutis. And so all these shrutis point out only one vakyam. That is Atma Brahma. That is the vakyam. So that is the Vakya Vichara. Then something has to be said about this Agama. And with that mantra comes to an end. Let us say that. Evam sarvatmanah sarva vishesha rahitasya chinmatra jyotishah brahmatva pratipadakasya vakyarthasya acharyopadesha paramparaya praptatvamaha. Okay, we are done with that agama. It is over now. This is the avatarika, introductory statement for the second half of the verse. Evam, in this way, so vakyarthasya acharyopadesha paramparaya praptatvamaha shrutihi. This vakyartha, now we have distilled the vakyas, two of them, and got the meaning of it. That is called vakyartha. That's why Vedanta Sabha is called Vakyartha Vichara. That is the word they use. Vakya is the sentence, artha is the spirit, the essence of it. So this Vakyartha, it is gained by, how did we gain it? Did we gain it by speculation? If you do speculation, you will be stuck at the level of that speculator, ego. At that level you get stuck. You may not be able to even work out that sakshad aparoksham, that category turiya. You may not be able to go beyond this tritiya. So third, that is the ego. 1, 2, 3, that's why they said third. The waking ego. So the chaturtham, the fourth, the turiya category, you may not be able to recognize. Even after gaining a familiarity with the sakshad aparoksham, knowing that it is this thing that I am seeking, the supreme reality that I am seeking is this sakshad aparoksham only. This cannot be appreciated by speculation and by surmising. So it is an agama. Agama means it is the realization of Mahatmas that is conveyed to the people. So that is the agama, and it is gained by acharya upadesha paramparaya. The Mahatmas who have this agama with them, they give it to the students in an incidental situation. That is how we gained it. That is what the Upanishadic sage is telling. We gained it that way. So what kind of vakyartha it is? Chinmatra jyotishaha brahmatva pratipadakasya. This vakyartha, the essence of it is chinmatra jyotish. The light of pure awareness, chideva chinmatram. It is awareness alone, nothing else. Awareness. So, you don't add anything to that. I am this, I am that, none of those things are added to that. It is just the awareness pure. That is under that awareness, why should you call it jyotihi, light? Because it lights up everything, including the ego. You go downwards to the world. The entire world comes to light in it. You go downwards. So that's why it is chinmatra jyotis. Don't add any adjectives to that. Sarva vishesha rahitasya. It is reflecting in a human body. Therefore you call it human being. It is being only, not human being. It is reflecting in an animal, and therefore you call it animal being. So don't add any adjectives to that. Because by the time you add an adjective, an epithet, it gets different from everything else. And the division is introduced into an undivided and indivisible reality. Therefore, don't add any epithets. Just leave it like that. So, like daylight. What is daylight? Don't add anything to daylight. Daylight is daylight. If you add daylight is the light, in light of a flower, then it is wrong. A flower comes to light in daylight. That's all. Daylight you cannot see. Everything else is seen in daylight. Daylight itself is not seen. So there are no epithets to daylight. So that is the light of Chaitanyam, and no epithets, no attributes to it. And that is the Sarvatma. It is the essential nature of every object of this universe, starting from a particle to the galaxies, Anuraniyan Mahatomahiyan. It is the Atma. Like saying, the smallest ornament and the biggest ornament have the same gold as their Atma. సో సర్వాత్మ ఇట్ ఈస్ అండ్ దట్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ బ్రహ్మ ద సుప్రీం రియాలిటీ ఈజ్ బీయింగ్ డిస్కస్డ్ అండ్ ప్రెజెంటెడ్ బై దిస్ వాక్యార్థ దట్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ వాక్యార్థ ఇట్ ఈస్ అండ్ దట్ వాక్యార్థ ఈజ్ రిసీవ్డ్ బై అస్ బై దిస్ లీనియేజ్ ఆఫ్ గ్రేట్ మహాత్మాస్ ఆచార్య ఉపదేశ పరంపరయా ప్రాప్తత్వం దిస్ ఈజ్ ది పాయింట్ విచ్ ఈస్ బ్రాట్ అవుట్ ఇన్ ది సెకండ్ హాఫ్ ఆఫ్ ది మంత్ర. ఓం పూర్ణమిదః పూర్ణమిదం పూర్ణాత్ పూర్ణముదచ్యతే పూర్ణస్య పూర్ణమాదాయ పూర్ణమేవావశిష్యతే. ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతిః. హరిః ఓం శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమః. హరిః ఓం తత్సత్ శ్రీకృష్ణార్పణమస్తు.